Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and welcome to part 5 of our tutorial series about using JSON data in After Effects. In this part, we will link this temperature line to our JSON file so that you just need to update those numbers in the file, and both the numbers and the line update in After Effects. The line is created in this precomp, so let's open it. The easy part is to link those numbers to the JSON document. We select this number, which shows the temperature at 0 o'clock, and connect it with our free tool mamoworldJSON to the JSON file. As name, we enter temperatureLine.0, which will store the value in the section temperatureLine under the name 0. Then we do the same for the 2 o'clock temperature, this time using the number temperatureLine.2. We continue in the same way to connect all other numbers. In the JSON document, we now have a section temperature line with all those numbers, and if we change any of them, the respective number in the After Effects project updates. Next, we also link the line to the data. The line is created by this shape layer. Here is the path of the line. Since we cannot link a path directly to JSON, we first want to link the vertices of the path to null layers. To do this, in the window menu, we select the Create Nulls from Paths panel. Unlike mamoworldJSON, this is not a script that you first need to download and install. It is already installed as part of the default After Effects installation. If we select the path and click the Points Follow Nulls button, you can see that a bunch of null layers are created, and if I move one of them, the path also changes. But somehow there is an offset between the position of the vertices of the path and the corresponding nulls. To fix this, we undo again and make sure that in the Transform section, both anchor point and the position are set to 0. If your path is nested deeply inside many groups, you may need to adjust the transforms of all those groups. Now, with the path selected, we click again on Create Nulls from Paths, and this time the nulls are exactly where they should be. Of course, the path itself is now in the wrong position, but we can fix that easily by selecting all the nulls and moving it back in place. If this workflow to link the points to null seems a bit tedious, you can also take a look at the paid extension Hooker, which is similar to Create Nulls from Paths script, but has many additional features. Now we can change the line by moving the null layers. Since we also want the label text to move with the line, we simply parent them to the respective null layers. If we now move a null, both the line and the label moves with it. The last missing step is to connect the nulls to the data in the JSON file. Since the temperature value should only move the nulls up and down and not left and right, we select the position of all null layers, right-click, and choose Separate Dimensions. Now we have separate properties for X and Y position. Let's link the Y position of the first null to the JSON file, as usual using mamoworldJSON. As name, we enter again temperatureLine.0, exactly as we did for the label text, since both should be driven by the same data in the JSON file. mamoworldJSON warns us that this entry already exists and asks whether the existing value should be overwritten. We actually want to keep this existing value of 20, since this is the correct temperature, and we don't want it to be replaced by the current position value of our null. As a consequence, the Y position of the null now changes to 20 pixels. Of course, this is not what we want because 20 is the temperature, but not the position value for the curve that corresponds to that temperature, so we need to find a way to convert the actual temperature to the corresponding position value. For this, we need to tweak the expression that connects the Y position to temperature data. As you've learned in the last part of this tutorial series, the first line here retrieves the value from the JSON file. We store this value now in a variable named temperature by writing var space temperature space equals in front of it. Then we add a semicolon at the end of the line, since we want to add a second command below it. In the next line, we will convert the actual temperature value into the corresponding position value using the linear function. We type linear and then in parentheses temperature, comma, minus 10, comma, 40, comma, 250, comma, 50. This looks very complicated, but is actually very easy once you understand it. It says I have temperature values in a range between negative 10 and 40 degrees and want to calculate the corresponding Y position values in the range between 250 and 50. So when the temperature is negative 10 degrees, the Y position should be 250, which is here at the bottom. And when the temperature is 40 degrees, the Y position should be 50, which is here at the top. So you just have to give the two extreme cases of what values you want to have for the lowest and highest temperature value you want to support, and the linear function calculates the values for all other possible temperatures based on that. You can see that if we set the temperature in the JSON file to negative 10, the Y position becomes 250. Now let's test the other extreme and set the temperature to 40 degrees. Now the Y position moved up to 50. So to make the line the way you want, you just have to adjust those numbers to control which result position you want to have for the lowest and highest temperature value. Or in other words, the statement just says, for temperatures between negative 10 and 40 degrees, please give me position values between 250 and 50. Now instead of repeating the same process for all nulls, we right-click on the property and choose Copy Expression Only. Then we select the Y positions of all other nulls and paste. Now all nulls are linked to the temperature value from 0 o'clock. So we open the expression for the 2 o'clock null and change the first line so that it retrieves the temperature value for 2 o'clock instead of 0 o'clock. All we need to do for this is to replace the 0 with a 2. Then we adjust the expressions on all other nulls in the same way. Now let's do some final tests and do some random changes to our JSON file. As you can see, both the curve and the labels update exactly as we want. So that's the end of our tutorial series about JSON data in After Effects. I know that this part was pretty technical, but I hope that I could convince you that with the help of mamoworldJSON and the linear expression linking charts and graphs to JSON data is not as complex as you might have expected. If you like this tutorial series, please visit mamoworld.com, where we have a lot of free tutorials and great products for After Effects. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamoworld.com, and we'll see you next time.